Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at FXBootcamp.com. Today is Wednesday, November 14th, 2012. It is 7:30 a.m. New York time, and this is a market alert video covering a potential opportunity on the euro-pound currency pair. What you're looking at is a four-hour chart for the euro-pound going back to about mid-September. Let me activate my drawing tool to highlight a key level here. Actually, you can see the level identified on this chart with a horizontal green line. A horizontal green line at 80.20. I'm going to highlight with a marker here some instances in which 80.20 seems to have affected price action on this pair over the past several weeks. On the left-hand side of the chart, you see some highs there, lows here. Perhaps you can even cite that low, this high. Lows here established around mid-October. Got a low there. Recall again, this is a four-hour chart. High there, and particularly the high established most recently, right there. Now you may have noticed on the far right-hand side of the chart, this pair has spiked higher, reaching I believe its highest point of the month, or at least matching the high point reached earlier this month. This likely on the back of news out of the UK, specifically the Bank of England. The UK Central Bank, the Bank of England, released at 5:30 a.m. New York time, this is 2 hours ago, its quarterly inflation report, which showed a downgraded economic outlook, a downgraded forecast by that central bank for the UK economy. In fact, after the release of that report, Bank of England Governor Mervyn King noted that the recovery in the UK, the economic recovery in the UK, would be slow unless the British pound were to weaken. So the British pound's broadly weak on the back of that report, on the back of those comments by Bank of England Governor Mervyn King. So I suspect more than a few traders are looking for opportunities to short the British pound today. The problem, the challenge for currency traders is to find a viable partner for the British pound. In other words, you know, what do you pair the British pound up against in terms of, you know, a currency pair to trade? If I look at, I'm not going to show you now, but if you look at the yen crosses, for example, the Japanese yen is broadly weak against several major currencies in response to some headlines out of Japan. It looks increasingly likely the Bank of Japan is going to have to do more stimulus. There's potentially an election coming up in Japan, and the looks like from reports earlier this week that the Japan's going into recession. So yen's broadly weak today. So weak Japanese yen, weak British pound, not a good match there. If I look at the dollar, for example, pound dollar currency pair is certainly a viable option. However, cable, the pair known as cable pound dollar, very close to its 200-day moving average. I mentioned the cable nearest 200-day moving average in a trend line in Monday's market situation report. Those sources of support near 58.50. Cable, as I speak, around 58.65 or so. So cable very close to some important perspective sources of support. So it's tough to short cable so close to some significant support levels. So what do I do? Well, if I look at the euro has been firming against multiple major currencies since the start of the week. I look at some of the markets that have seemed to have influenced euro price action of late, and those markets, at least thus far today, are if anything euro positive. For example, the Greek stock market is up about 1.5% today. The Spanish 10-year bond yield is down moderately today. Now, if those markets were moving in opposite directions, those would be euro negative. So if anything, those markets in Europe are at least a moderate euro positive. So what's positive for the euro is generally negative for the dollar. So a weaker dollar today, if that theme continues, is going to be a tough match against a weaker British pound. So the idea here is this: it's reasonable to consider opportunities to long the euro pound currency pair. And I cited that 80.20 level earlier because, again, it's influenced price action on several occasions over the past several weeks. Let's get down to a shorter term time frame and look at a potential trade opportunity. Here's a 15-minute chart for the euro pound. I've got the 80.20 level again identified by a green line. And that, my friends, is basically the opportunity. A long at or near the 80.20 level. In fact, you could also do a Fib study of the move up from today's low down here into the bottom of the chart to the high thus far around 80.37. Let's do that now. .2% Fib, we're near that now. The 50% Fib of that move up is just below the 80-20 level, again represented by the horizontal green lines. So again, the 50% fib, very common, very popular amongst traders who use fib levels. So the idea is this: along at or near, and I stress the word near, at or near 80-20, stop loss options. Let me identify this with a marker here. Exit strategy could be a dip either below the 61.8% fib there, just below 80.15, or perhaps a dip below the 78.6% fib right there at about 80.08. Profit targets, let me expand the scale of this chart. You got a 161.8% fib of the earlier move up. That 161.8% fib extension around 80.60. You've also got, if I move this a little more, the weekly M4 pivot point around 80.50, a weekly R2 pivot point around almost at 80.70. So you've got a zone here, which I don't have access to my marker here, but you've got a zone here between about 80.50 and almost 80.70 that represents a potential profit target, a target zone for the euro pound bulls. So again, potential euro pound opportunity during today's New York morning session. Again, today is Wednesday, November 14th, and as I speak, about 7:37 a.m. New York time.